agriculture is key in our provinces. We understand that even our new provincial development plan has been actually revised to really look strongly on the agriculture as a very critical area, as a niche in ensuring that we change the socio-economic outlook of our province. We are open and engaging with our communities to ensure that we transform that space, and our people really give a space to government, and government work with cooperatives, with all the farmers. We would love to continue affirming organic farmers. We don't want people who think about agriculture and farming as a leisure. It must be about a cornerstone of our economic development, support for food production, not for only the province, for our country. We've seen it already that farmers here, they've been actually exporting the maize outside the country. We've got Almawash case that has been sorted now recently, where we are also exporting the livestock, the sheep to other countries. So it's huge. We are endowed here with a high number of the livestock as compared to other countries. We should be actually producing more red meat than anyone else. So the livestock improvement program is meant to deal with such issues and get ourselves focused on the real issues in terms of that. If you talk about stimulating economy, use what is actually possible, and that also has the potential for you to be able to take our province to another level. It has actually reached now other levels of the proportion where people are being killed for their livestock, and these thieves are very much ruthless and aggressive. But we have deployed South African National Defence Force officers here, as well as South African police services, who are monitoring this place, especially the borders between us and Lesotho. Recently, we have even arrested soldiers from Lesotho who were caught in this problem of livestock here. So it tells you that it's an organised syndicate that deals with this issue. Definitely, any high rate of crime is a threat to economic development, because government must create conducive environment for investors to come and invest. And if that is not happening, if there's a high rate of crime, no investors will feel comfortable to come and invest their money here. So we've got to deal with that from a government point of view. We've done arrests, be it Kumbu, be it Ngobo, be it here. We've been arresting people. So we just need to have this kind of a collaborative effort between the in the justice system to ensure that we don't just arrest and get also people running away with a murder. And our people cannot be living a fearful life at this day and age. Our people must be free, must understand, must enjoy the meaning of being liberated, so that they can wake up and be productive in our country, in the society at large. That's why government has established that the system to look after the military veterans across. And this is happening across. We're giving them houses, we're giving them this support. They are actually doing a lot of business initiatives across the actually the corporate spectrum. It's not only in the agriculture, everywhere where they are. Some are in the financial sectors, others are in other areas of the economy. So we are supporting them where we can, and yes, we have not done enough. That's one thing that has been unfortunate about us as a country. We still have them, some dying as paupers, and these are things that we should have actually resolved long time ago.